हाँ,
डेंसिटी
डेंसिटी इज द मेजर ऑफ मास पर यूनिट वैल्यू एट कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर. वी मस्ट इंक्लूड द वर्ड कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर. लास्ट टाइम वन ऑफ यू आर आस्किंग डाउट, ऋषित वॉज आस्किंग डाउट, इफ यू इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर वॉट हैपन्स टू डेंसिटी. तो एक्चुअली डेंसिटी वी शुड डिफाइन एज अ मास पर यूनिट वैल्यू. If we increase the temperature, then volume will also increase, then density decreases. So actually we will not talk about that density variation with temperature right now. We'll be talking only about density in the constant temperature, that is mass per unit volume, which shows how much heavy an object is at constant volume like that. Symbol is rho, 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 r density, d. Okay. You can use both the symbols. Formula, rho is equal to mass by volume, which is equal to m by v. SI unit, mass unit is kg, volume unit is meter cube. So you can write it as kg per meter cube or kg meter to the power of minus 3. Okay. CGS unit, gram per centimeter cube or centimeter cube only, you can write it as cc, cubic centimeter, gram per cc or gram per centimeter to the power of minus 3. These two are units for density. So let us go for units of volume. Volume, first we should learn volume units actually. So the volume units are meter cube or centimeter cube. Centimeter cube only can be written as cc or cubic centimeter or liter. Liter is also one of the unit for volume, and milliliter is also unit for volume. Okay, and so if you see volume conversions, 1 meter cube is equal to 10 power 6 centimeter cube. That means 1 meter is actually 10 power 2 centimeter, and 1 meter cube is equal to 10 power 6 centimeter cube. Or 1 centimeter cube is 10 power minus 6 meter cube. Okay. The next, 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liter, meter cube and liter conversion. 1 meter cube of volume is same as 1000 liters of volume. Or 1 centimeter cube is same as 1 milliliter. Okay. These are the some volume conversions. Based on this, we will be solving some worksheets. So that is why I am telling you all this. Okay. These are SI and CGS units. These are volume units. These are volume conversion. Some other units of density like kg per liter or gram per milliliter is also density unit. For example, mass is taken in kg and volume is taken in liter. So then kg per liter is also a unit. If mass is taken as gram and volume is taken as milliliter, then gram per milliliter is also a unit for density. Yeah, some of the units, kg per liter and gram per milliliter also there, some of the other units of density. Though SI unit of density is kg per meter cube, for convenience we use gram per centimeter cube for solids, gram per milliliter for liquids and gram per liter for gases. One more point. Density is a scalar quantity. Density is a scalar quantity. And if you take the units, other units of density, that is kg per liter or gram per milliliter or gram per cc, all are numerically equal. They are numerically equal. For example, if any material density is 100 kg per liter, then in gram per milliliter units also it is 100 gram per milliliter only. In gram per cc also 100 gram per cc only. That is what numerically equal means.
Read what you told just now.
Let us learn density conversion between SI and CGS units. SI unit of density is kg per meter cube and CGS unit of density is gram per centimeter cube. What is the relation between them? 1 kg, you can write it as 10 power 3 grams. And 1 meter cube, you can write it as 10 power 6 centimeter cube, and which is equal to 10 power 3 minus 6. Gram per centimeter cube, and if you further simplify, 10 power minus 3 gram per centimeter cube. So the relation between 1 kg per meter cube and gram per centimeter cube is 1 kg per meter cube is equal to 10 power minus 3 gram per centimeter cube. And if you want to convert from gram per centimeter cube to kg per meter cube, yes, you send this 10 power 3, 10 power minus 3, right, left,
no,
please stop, wait, Shruti,
Arun,
I will give time for doubts, please wait, or 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 10 power 3 kg per meter cube. So for example, water density 10 power 3, and if you want to convert it into CGS unit, multiply into 10 power minus 3, you will get it as 1. Okay. And mercury density is 13.6 in CGS units. If you want to convert it into SI units, 13.6 into 10 power 3, you do, and you will get SI units. Some of you are asking many other materials density also. So for different density of liquids, you can go through this link. For different densities of solids, you can go through this link. There are many materials densities has been given in this website. Let us try to understand the physical meaning of density also. For example, density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube. What is the meaning of this statement? The meaning of this statement is, in 1 meter cube of volume, we can store or we can keep 1000 kg of water. That is what it means. And in the case of water, 1 liter volume of water weighs 1 kg mass. Okay. 1 liter volume of water weighs 1 kg mass. This is true only for water. But if you take oil, 1 liter volume of oil weighs 9-10 grams or 0.91 kg. Some of you have asked, the highest density material is osmium, 22.6 gram per centimeter cube or 22,600 kg per meter cube. aluminium density is 2739 kg per meter cube. That means 2739 kg of aluminium can be fitted in 1 meter cube volume. Okay, or 5478 kg of aluminium can be fitted in 2 meter cube of volume. Lowest density material is air medium. It has 1.225 kg per meter cube density.
Sir, how air has lowest density? Water has 1 kg per meter cube density.
Water is 1000 kg per meter cube density.
Gram per centimeter.
Sir, if the air has the lowest density, how can some particles float in air then?
What is happening? Actually, they are recently found lowest density solid.
Sir, what is the density of iron?
Aerogel, that is 0.16 milligram per cc. Air density is 1.225 kg per meter cube. And aerogel is made up of carbon. They have made it. Scientists, they have made it. Aerogel, it is made up of carbon.
What is the density